Bless the Lord with me. It's yet another morning. We've woken up full of God's mercy, God's grace, and the love of God is together with us. I can feel the love of God together with us. I can feel the grace of the Almighty God. The Bible says His mercies are new every morning. This is yet another morning when we are candidates of His mercy and grace. You've woken up very early today, and we bless the Lord together with you. Thank you for being at the feet of Jesus. And we want to welcome you to today's devotional. My name is Pastor Moses. So as we begin, I want us to pray. Let's bow our head for a word of prayer. Lord Jesus, in Jesus' name, we are before your throne of mercy, O God, this morning. We know that, Father, you have good plans for us, plans to prosper us and not to harm us, plans to give us a hope and a future full of expectations. Lord, we want to bless your name this morning as we embark into this devotional this morning, Jehovah Father. We pray that, God, you minister to us. Let your grace and mercy, grace that is new every morning, be sufficient for us. We bless your name and we worship you. Lead us through this session, my Father, and minister to our hearts and minister to our needs. In Christ's name we pray and believe. Amen. Thank you very much. And I now want us to go to the word. And today I want us to meditate on the word priest or high priest. Who is a high priest? And who is a priest? A person who goes before the Lord on your behalf is a priest. There was a time in the Old Testament when people would not approach God directly, but they would approach God through a high priest. And today I want us to look at his functions and the things that he does in our lives. During this devotion, I pray that the Lord will help us to understand that we've got a high priest. So help me get your Bible and let's turn to the book of Hebrews chapter 5 and verse 14. And I will read, "Therefore, since we have a great high priest who has gone through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold firmly to the faith we profess. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who has been tempted in every way, just as we are, yet without sin. Let us then approach the throne of grace with confidence, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need." Brethren, today when I was thinking about this word, I felt like I needed to know exactly who is a priest in order to understand this portion of scripture. And those days when people had sin, people would go to a priest, probably would carry a lamb and go to a priest and speak to him and tell him about what you have done. A priest would listen to you. They would take the sin, put it and all the blame upon a lamb, and would release a lamb to the wilderness to be eaten by the beasts and the beasts of the desert. This way, people would be relieved of their sins. It used to be called a scapegoat. But now here we are living at the time of mercy and grace. This is the dispensation of grace, whereby we have a priest who is a great high priest who is intervening and speaking to God on our behalf, Jesus Christ. When Jesus came, the curtains were torn. When Jesus died, the curtains were torn on the pulpit, and we are able to approach God one on one. And this is what we are doing today in these 21 days of prayer. We've been given authority and we've been given right to approach the Lord in prayer and speak to Him one on one. And the Bible says that we have a great high priest who has gone through the heaven, Jesus, Son of God. And He is telling us, let us hold firmly to the faith we profess. And at this time, when people are going through trials, it's very easy for people to lose faith. It's very easy to question whether God is still there, whether Christ is there, whether he's listening to us. But the Bible says he has gone through the same things that we have gone through. He can be able to sympathize with us. He can be able to empathize with us. He can be able to feel our cries. Even at the time when we are not able to pray, he can feel our cries. He can come to our aid. And therefore today as we pray, I want you to know that the Bible tells us, God's word, that we have a great high priest who has gone through the things we've gone through, who can sympathize with us, who can empathize with us. He can feel us. He can feel you. He can feel the cries in your heart, even those unspoken needs that you cannot be able to speak. Those things that I'm feeling like, these ones I can't even share with my brethren. I can't share with anyone. Today I want to speak to us fervently that we have a great high priest who has gone through it and he can be able to sympathize with us. He's speaking to God on our behalf. And that's why verse 16 says, "Let us therefore approach the throne of grace with confidence, knowing that we have a priest who cares for us, one who speaks on our behalf, one who cares for our needs, one who has gone through what we have gone through. He was once human. The feelings and the pains that we go through, he knows. He knows you, my brother. He knows you, my sister. He knows the things that you are placing in front of him today in prayer. He knows that when we approach his throne in prayer, he knows what we are asking. Even before we ask, he already knows. He just says, knock and the door shall be open. Ask and it shall be given to you. So today as we are praying, I want to beseech you that go before him in confidence, knowing that the Lord has gone before us and he's listening to us. He's turning his ear to us. His ear is open to our cries and he can listen to us. We have confidence. We approach his throne with confidence, knowing that he is there and he can listen to us. The Bible says in part B of verse 16 that so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. I believe this is our time of need. I believe as a nation, this is our time of need. I believe as families, this is our time of need. I believe as a people, this is our time of need. There are so many needs that we're bringing before the Lord. Maybe some of us, your jobs are no longer making profit. You are running in losses. Others have gone into very big debts. But I want to beseech you by the mercies of God that let's take it to the Lord in prayer. There's a song that I like singing. What a friend we have in Jesus. What a privilege to carry everything to the Lord in prayer. When we go down on our knees and we ask God, he listens, he sympathizes, he empathizes, he listens to our cry and he hears us, even our deepest needs and those things that we cannot be able to mention. What a friend we have in Jesus. But the only thing that we need to do is to go to his feet in prayer and ask God, Almighty God, we are on your feet this morning. We are in your presence this morning. Lord, we know that you sympathize with us. You know us even before we call. Call unto me, the Bible says, and I will answer you. And I will show you great and unsearchable things. We want to know the mind of God. We shall call unto him today. We shall call unto him in the noontime. We shall call unto him in the evening. We shall not cease. We will not cease to pray. We will call unto his name in the morning, in the noontime, and in the evening. So even as we finish, as we pray, I want us to bow down our heads, knowing well that we have a priest, high priest, great high priest, who is able to sympathize and empathize with us. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, indeed, we have listened to your word this morning. We know that, Lord, you are full of sympathy and you know our heart aches. You know our disappointments. You know the things we go through. You know that, my Father, when we come to you, O Lord, you answer us. We are confident that, Jehovah, you are there for us and you are listening to us, my Father. And Lord, because you are our priest, we can come to you in confidence so that we can receive grace and mercy even to go through this day. Probably the day may be very difficult, but Jehovah, you provide grace. The day may be very hard, but Lord, you shall provide grace enough for the day. Oh God, your mercy that is new every morning is what we rely on. And Father, we are praying. I pray for the listeners. I pray for the viewers this morning that God give us enough mercy and grace to go through this day. May your Holy Spirit, oh Jehovah God, remind us that God, you are there for us, that you are intervening on our situations, that Father, you are coming through for that business that is not making profit. You are coming through for that mama who is seeking you this morning and seeking to meet with you, seeking you for his family, seeking you for the salvation of his children, of her children. Lord, we are praying for these families that, God, you intervene. We call upon your name, Jehovah, knowing that, Father, you hear us. We are not like those people who don't have a father. We have a Father in heaven. Lord, we are not orphans, but we are together with you. We know that you are with us and you hear us. And that's why we have confidence this morning, even to wake up early, my Father, and to call on your name. Because, Jehovah God, you hear us and you shall answer to our cries. We bless your name, my Father. Help us even when we continue these 21 days of prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Shalom, and may the peace of the Lord be with you all. Amen.